show you something here. Every word that I need to mess with. The first word is manifest. He said, your work will be made manifest. Well, what is your work, Apostle Jones? It's whatever you're doing for God and how you're living, whether you, watch this here, whether you're living it with your whole heart or whether you're faking it. See, we got a lot of folk in here that are actors and actresses. They know how to play their role. But when God puts you in certain situations, you'll forget your lines. You'll forget what you're supposed to say and how you're supposed to act. And then we'll wind up seeing the real you. And everybody is shocked because they never seen that part. Somebody said, but it was there all the time. It just took the fire to expose what was hidden. Oh God, I feel you now. Look at somebody say, it all come out in the fire. Oh God, I don't really know who I'm dealing with now. Some of y'all married some folk, thought they were good folk. But soon if it got heated up, you start seeing other stuff that you did not see before you said, I do. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Now you said, if I would have knew. All you had to do is sit back and watch God put them in the fire. And whatever they got on them, they're not like God will be manifested in the fire. It's easy to play your role when all your bills are paid and everybody's been running from the house. When you don't need your money, when the children are acting right, and ministry is going. Everything is just hunky-dory. It is easy to play your role then. But what happened in the crunch time? What happened in the fourth quarter? What happened with a few seconds to pay the bill? What happened when you get the cutoff notice? Y'all don't want me to put you here. What happened when Sister So-and-so rolled up on you and called herself judging you and caught you in the back? Y'all don't want me to pray. What do you do when the last prophet walk up to you and try to prophesy to you in the parking lot? Stay right there, but I can hurt you right there because some of you don't act the same way in our presence as you do at home. You don't want me to preach right now. You don't act the same way on your job. You don't talk to your husband all sweet. When you're at the house, there's another spirit that arises up. There's another manifestation that arises up. Well, why those manifestations are there? Because and when you're in the church, the anointing got the fire. And mercy. Surely grace and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That's good scripture. But do you take grace for granted? No, you don't. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There comes a time in your life when you got to master your sin. There comes a time in your life when you got to operate in self-control. There comes a time in your life when you got to learn how to love the unlovable. There comes a time in your life when you got to believe God. Ain't nobody gonna be there.
But the reason God can't build on you.
is your foundation can't sustain the weight of God's glory. You should have already been a worldwide evangelist. Should have already been all over the country. But Lord said, every time I put the weight on you, your foundation crumble. Your foundation give. Because you can't handle the weight. Look at your neighbor and say, you're going to have to be able to handle the weight. You're going to have to be able to take your own cross. You're going to have to be able to go through something. You're going to have to be able to pray your way out. You're going to have to be able to go on that word and get a word for yourself and speak into your own spirit.
Come on.
And I'm going to prophesy and I'm going to lay hands for about 5 minutes. Now, if you're in your flesh, don't even worry about me coming your way. Yeah, I ain't going to be able to pull you. One thing about me, I thank God for being liberated. Because a few niggas can't control or dictate the way I preach. Or hear what I'm saying. See, I feel like this. If I preach the word of the Lord has a responsibility to take care of me. I ain't worried about church folk, because church folk move based upon their condition. One of the biggest lies that the devil tells you that you're going to have time to get it right and ain't nobody really going to ever find out about it. But God already know about it. And you blessed if he ain't told the prophet yet. If he ain't told the prophet yet, that still means you're operating under grace. Now you got some folks going to run and bring personal information, and that's not God. You cannot move on personal information, because if you move on personal information, now you're operating in another spirit. You're not in the spirit of what I said. You're not in the prophetic dimension now. Now you're moving in divination. And God told them to come. No. That was a busy night. That was a busybody, a gossip, or a tale there. Somebody that wanted something juicy so they could spread it to tie down the character and the integrity of somebody else and keep the focus off of them. Come on, man. So the next word that I got to use, he said that there is a day that would declare it. Hear what Paul is saying. There is an appointed time before the foundation of the world, because the God we know is not the simple-minded God that preachers try to preach to you. He's the all-knowing God. My God, from the time he created you and gave you purpose, he knew the end of your life and everything that you would do that was not like him all the way through your life. But he never made a decision based on the stupid stuff that you've done in the middle part, because he never looks at us in the middle part. He looks at us at the end. Now, what my job is when you're in the middle part of your life, in the middle, you're struggling between the end and the beginning. When you're stuck in the middle, my job is to remind you of the, watch this, of the penalty for not fulfilling your purpose and not obeying the God-breathed word. Are you hearing what I say? My job, this is what I come to do. Let's come here. Stand right here. See, there are many times that you won't tell the truth because you're trying to throw folks off. There are many times when, come on, you're walking with God, come on. And you get so far to stop. And there is unseen forces. Look at your neighbor and tell him, you ain't got a clue. There are unseen forces that can identify the purpose of God because of the anointing that they see.